Can you unlock that door for us? It's stuck.
Okay, guys, today we're going to start off with hoop aerobics. So I want everybody to walk carefully and have a seat inside of a hoop. One person per hoop.
Who taught last time?
Me.
Okay.
And
okay. Okay.
Once you are finished, you have to come back home and have a seat. Okay? So I need everybody to stand up. Whenever I say go, I want you to leap over 10 different loops and then return home. Go. Let's move on to the next activity, kind of make up for some of our time that we lost. Thank you.
Yeah, you have to adjust with your hands, crawl up the rope. Joya, did you ever do double dutch? No. Yeah. You see how they started tight first? Yeah. Everybody feels that way the first day, Chelsea. Are we doing the one in the dynamic physical education book with the window, or are we doing the Australian?
So we're going to do the window.
Yes, the window is the American version. That is the American version. That is the window.
Most people. I know.
I'm trying to get him to.
If you have good turners, it makes your life much easier.
Hold this one like that. Long as possible. This one right here. Choke
them up somewhere. Yeah, so you have to choke up on it. Good job. I think we've got it over here. Go get behind JT. Tight. Okay. Watch the window. One, two, three, go. Do you see the window? One up, one down. And make sure you get all the way to the middle, otherwise the rope will catch you. Okay, let's go. Come on. She just added another group so more people can practice. Try to get all the way to the middle. Okay, your timing was fine. Justin, yeah. You just weren't all the way in the middle.
Right. Hey, but you could jump on your feet, right?
Oh, yeah.
Because it goes over both sides.
Right.
Hey, guys,
I didn't know that.
Get that clickety click going. Hear that click. He needs to hear the beat. One of your things is not here hitting. They both need to hit. There we go.
Yeah,
Yeah, guys, you're going to mess him up. Yeah, it's got to hit. Let me, somebody come hold it. Come hold it. Get.
You did that one good, Miss Connie.
Thank you. Not my first rodeo. Stay a double dutch. Oh, he got in. We have two people in today. We got to get in at least one more. You really are. It's really good. Good turner.
Hey, look, when you see the one on my left hand hit the ground, right there, after you hit the ground, you run straight to the middle, right?
It's going to
be easy for you, though. Oh, we messed it up.
I'm out of it there, ropes are tangled.
Come out here.
Only one of your ropes are hitting. Choke up on the long one, and so that you can get both of them to hit. He got in. He couldn't keep it going, but at least he got in. That's the hardest part, is getting in. They get discouraged so quickly. Way to go, Catherine. That's great. First day. Oh. What big fifth graders we are.
Go into the free area and start jumping.
Good. I'll give you a little hint. You back up enough where you're not hitting, you're not actually going to touch the other person. You're just all jumping at the same time. You know, you back up, separate yourself at first for quite a while. Like that. That is correct. Just make sure you don't get in. But it has to be synchronized. All together. Well, we got two of them going. Yeah, if you get out of sync, you're going to mess her rope up. Okay, let's try again. Look at this! Are they not coordinated or what? The next stage is that your rope goes over her. Brian may have some difficulty there. It's not hitting the floor for him. Okay. Jump high, Brent.
One, two, three, begin.
I think try again. Kind of looks like a spider web. That blue rope is really short. Brent's going to have a hard time getting over it. stretching teachers. Chelsea, take over. They did. I think it goes on the floor.
In the description it says hold it up in the air and toss it.
Like this, and you swing your leg over it and catch it before.
With two fingers.
Because in the book it says it throw it up.
You can try to get them to do that. I don't know how they're going to do that. Try it both ways, guys. Got to catch it with same hand. Oh, yes. Yes, he is awesome. Does it say how you hold the wand? Thank you. You see majorettes do this in the bands.
Okay, this one, you're going to put both hands on the wand like this. Just two fingers from each hand. And I know all of y'all have done this when maybe y'all at like Walmart or something. Put your hands on the pole like this and jump over it. So this is what you're going to do with the wand. You just put your hands like this and you're just going to jump over it. But don't jump backwards. It says in the book, do not jump backwards because something could go wrong.
Yes. I think you're right.
Yeah, keep going there. They're going to go behind you like this. It is kind of hard. Everybody put them on. Okay, this one's the balancing wand. Now we're going to balance it on two fingers or even in your palm. It's probably easier. You're just going to do that for a few seconds, and then you're going to keep balancing, and we're going to sit down and stand up. So, try to sit down while you're balancing it.
Put three pennies on top. That's a little harder, isn't it?
Come on, Tutu. Try hold it for just 3 seconds.
Can anybody do it? If anybody can do it, he can do it. A little bit harder than balancing feathers, isn't it?
I love the way
He feels so bad. I bet somebody can do this one. Brent got 2 seconds. She did it. Catherine's not bad either.
Has ever done that before. You're just gonna switch your feet over the wand, but do not let your feet touch the wand. So you have to make sure they come off the ground. You can't drag them like most people do to make it easy. You have to jump, pretty much jump over.
Demo.
We're gonna do 10 of them. So everybody count to 10 out loud. Then we'll see who can do it the fastest. So just practice. Yeah, there you go.
There we go.
With 1 foot over the wand.
Even with blue jeans on, he can do it.
Yeah. Okay, now we're going to go to 20, and we're going to see who can do it the fastest. So, if somebody touches their wand, I'm going to be watching y'all. If somebody touches it, that person will be out. So, whenever I blow my whistle, everybody starts, and we're going to count out loud, even though it'll be off. That way I'll know who's going to win. So,
let's not use our whistle to start.
Set. Come grab one bean bag in the bucket over here and go back to your wand. And just set the beanbag down next to your wand whenever you get here, and then I'll explain.
Brian, look
at that. Hurry, hurry, hurry. Run out of time.
Put the rubber end on the floor if you have a rubber end. Mom, roll it here. No bending your knees.
I just want to bust my face.
Try it. Okay, so once the
Catherine
down,
can
stand back up, and then you're going to have to go back down and get your back.
You get stuck over there. You can't get back up. Never done that before.
So just try and like throw it up and like catch it. Try not to let it hit the ground.
Good job, Ron.
You want to catch it with one hand.
Oh,
one
hand? Same hand?
Throw it up. If you throw it up with your right hand, you're going to catch it with your right hand.
And you got to make it flat.
This is kind of dangerous.
For little kids, if you don't spread them out. Yeah. This would not be a first grade activity. We would use feathers, wouldn't we? For little bitty kids, we use feathers.
We don't. Everybody come put their wand up. And we're going to do juggling, but this time we are not using scarves. We've been doing it long enough. You either grab a bean bag, you grab a ball, or you can grab the ring.
Go ahead and begin as soon as you get out there, because we need all the practice we can get.
Hurry up. Did you grab the bean bag, the ball, or that black bag, the ring?
Yes. We already have two.